Police Minister Mr. Natim Tetwa told Parliament that the head of the South African Police Service's Crime Intelligence Unit, Lieutenant General Richard Mdluli, had been removed from his post. Minister Mtetwa told an extended public committee on his budget vote that allegations had been leveled against Lieutenant General Mdluli insofar as it related to mismanagement of funds and nepotism. Minister Mtetwa said there had been unfortunate public accusations and counter-accusations within the management of SAPS. What seemed to have sparked this was a widely reported letter which Lieutenant General Mdluli was reported to have written to, among others, the Minister of Police. Minister Mtetwa said this letter seemed to have political connotations and had caused tensions within the management of SAPS. It alluded to a conspiracy theory of some in the management ganging up against him.
I have instituted a team led by the state law advisor to investigate such allegations because they are so serious as to suggest the meddling of policing function in politics. Whilst this probe is underway, we have, in consultation with the acting National Commissioner of Police, decided that Lieutenant General Mdluli should be shifted from his current position with effect today as the head of crime intelligence and moved to another division as determined by the acting National Commissioner. To this end, Lieutenant General Mdluli Lieutenant General Mdluli has been informed of the decision and has pledged his support to this process. We shall therefore allow and observe this process to be carried through without any undue interference. I am deliberately and purposefully reiterating the clarity of process on all these current cases and investigations because over a period of time, there had been some misrepresentation, false allegations, and to a certain extent, genuine concerns about the goings on within SAPS. We have resisted the temptation, and we shall stick to our principles of respect for all legal processes of the land.
In his address, Minister Mtetwa highlighted the priorities identified by the police department. These included stepping up the fight against rhino poaching and also crimes against women and children.
One of the disturbing criminal acts into the past year has been rhino poaching, wherein this alone, over 200 rhinos were killed. As such, this has been declared an operational priority by the Department of Police. A national task team has been established at the DPCI to specifically address this matter. And again, government at all levels has been engaging particularly our counterparts in countries of East Asia to enhance law enforcement agencies. We have had a meeting with my counterpart in Vietnam in October last year, particularly on this matter, and we got assurance and commitment to cooperate and work together. On women, children, and people with disability, having re-established the Family Violence, Child Protection, and Sexual Offences Unit, we have gone around the country interacting with men and women who are working in this area. We have also raised a matter of scarce skills because we believe that people who work in this area work in a very specialized area and they need all the support from government and everybody else. Crime against women and children is a priority for SAPS, and therefore the FCS, having been introduced in all 176 SAPS clusters and in all 9 provinces, is starting to work effectively.
Another priority area for the police was the building of police stations. Following the saga with leases of police buildings, SAPS and the Department of Public Works were now working together to ensure people's access to police services in their backyards where they live.
That is why this priority of building police stations was emphasized, that it is a priority which need to be achieved so that those who have not benefited with such service do benefit.
The police had also begun to address the way in which police should deal with public protesters. New equipment had now been procured, which would enable the police to deal with these situations and to ensure that accusations of police brutality were being addressed.
To that extent, I would want to urge the public that whilst the police would be and are continuing to approach the public protest and such public functions in a manner, in a humane manner, we also expect the same from the public. We have a situation where in Heidelberg, in Gauteng, for instance, police have been pursuing this path, which we said it's correct to pursue, but with difficulty because some of the people in the community have been very violent. And we want people to bear with the police that when we say they must approach people humanely, we also speak to everyone that nobody has a license to destroy somebody else's property.